Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Ekiman, and welcome back to another episode of our Minecraft Let's Play on the Hypercraft server. Okay, so I have been quite busy since the last episode. As you can see, I've got a few more random chests in here. Need to arrange this a bit more. But I've been doing a bit of caving and collecting clay blocks. So you can see here I've got myself some gold horse armor, a saddle. We've got a couple of music discs and a name tag as well. And obviously a bunch of different clay blocks here as well. And so let's go take a look at what I've been up to. Oh, actually, just before we get started, I've got a temporary horse over here. This is one I found while I was out exploring. It's not a particularly fast or a good jumper or anything like that, but it was the only one I could find, so I just grabbed that and brought it home. But yeah, we're going to go looking for a better horse pretty soon and use that gold horse armor on it. But yeah, let's go take a look down here, because I have been working on the spider spawner that was down here near our base. So you can see that's where the spawner was in there. I've just enclosed all that. And yeah, this isn't finished yet. This isn't going to be the way to get in. I'm going to make a ladder up to the top and a little entrance area up there maybe, or something like that. But yeah, this is just basically the same spider farm that I had in my single player world, which is actually DocM77's design. So some of you will have already seen this in my regular world. So basically you just stand here, wait for the spiders to come down. When you've got enough gathered, you close them off in there. Come down here, and then you can activate this crusher here. It's just a manual one at the moment. I do want to... bit of lag there. I do want to hook up a automated, you know, a proper crusher. A timed crusher, sorry, that's what I was trying to say. But I ran out of redstone, so I had to put that off, unfortunately. So yeah, today we are going to do a bit of caving, because I need to resupply some things. I'm totally out of redstone, and I have no diamond at all. I did find some on one of my previous caving runs, but I got blown up by a creeper, so I lost the lot. So yeah, no diamond yet. This thing's working quite good. I'm quite pleased with it. Did have a few problems with spiders grouping up here, but I've solved that now. Just had to update the water flow. I'd forgotten to do it up there, so there was a dead spot. Let's just kill these guys off, and then we might go and put an enchant on something. Man, sure, we're not going to get to level 30 off of these guys. Let's grab that. So, yeah, I've got a nice collection of wool going on, so I'm thinking about using that in a future build. So I'm probably going to have to AFK down here at some point and collect a bunch more string. But yeah, for now, let's just... Let's just get to level 30 before we finish this up. I have enchanted myself a couple of picks, so I've got this efficiency 4 one, but then I also got this good pick as well, so if we find some diamonds, that'll be what we use. And I had this as well. Oh, that was the last sword I enchanted as well. I'm still using all my level 1 enchanted iron gear here. Haven't upgraded any of that yet. Although I do have enough iron to make a new set. Let's just kill these guys. I'm not going to bother with the crusher. And there we go, level 30. So, what can we go and make? Well, we've only got a power 1 bow, so maybe we could go and make a good bow. So, let's just head back up to the base. Oh, actually, there's a few things around spawn we can go and take a look at as well, although some of you will have probably already seen this on other people's videos. We've got a spawn hub now as well. The guys got together and built us a cool spawn hub, so we'll go take a look at that. But also, you can have a look at the other guys' channels. I think Albanackers, Woolly Creeper, and Benito and Ruby, I think, have all got videos up on it. There may be some more as well, so apologies if I missed anyone there. But yeah, you can check out the list of hyperminers. All their YouTube channels will be in the description of this video as always, so you can go and check them out, which I highly recommend you go and do. Of course, that's not right, is it? There we go. Let's just do that, and we'll grab ourselves a new bow. And store all this stuff. Yeah, I'm rapidly running out of storage space, so we're going to have to start going to look for a location for our base as well now. Oh, that was... Get out of here. Yeah, those slime balls took me ages to get, because obviously we don't... I don't think we've got a slime farm anywhere yet, so I was roaming around a marsh biome trying to get that sorted for quite some time. I had to wait until we got a full moon before I actually found any. So first thing we should go and check out is the spider spawner that Wooly put up, and also Benito has done a potion dispenser thing down here as well that we'll go take a quick look at as well. You might have already seen this though, but yeah, we'll go check it out. So this is the spider spawner. Not spider spawner, we've just been there. This is the skelly spawner. This is Wooly Creeper's design. What did we get there? Ooh, Aqua Affinity. Excellent. Yeah, that's not too bad, actually. Anyway, we're not going to mess with those guys. I just want to come over here and let's put a level 30 on that. Flame 1, Punch 1. Yeah, it's not too bad. Although, we could really combine it with that Power 1, I guess. Let's just see how many levels would that take. 20. What about if we do it that way? 35. So, maybe I will... Nah, I think we'll be okay. We'll go with what we have. I will mess around with combining my stuff later on, although that sword is a bit worse for wear. Maybe I should have made a sword and enchanted that, but no problem. So anyway, before we go caving, let's go take a look at the new additions to spawn as well. So if you've seen Armitage's video, you will have probably already seen the tree farm that we've got up here that he built with Talon Wolf. But we're going to go and take a look at that anyway. Looks like Ruby's got an obscenity on top of his building there. Either that or it's an arrow, or rather dodgy looking arrow. Anyway, let's get over here. And we will check out... Oh, also, yeah, I think the Iron Trench is up and running as well. I'm not sure if we actually took a look at that when we were last here. I think we looked at the chicken farm, but we didn't take a look at this. So yeah, Talon Wolf's been hard at work on this thing, the Iron Trench, which was designed by Tango Tech. And yeah, this thing is crazy. So yeah, over here we've also got the... Can we get to it on these lily pads? This is our spawn tree farm. Haven't actually used it yet, but... I needed to get some spruce wood, so I will be coming over here at some point and farming myself some wood. Very cool design, I really like the look of this. And obviously everything just filters its way down here. This is part of the Iron Trench as well. I'm not quite sure. Oh, is this the villager area? I don't know. So yeah, let's go take a look at the spawn hub as well. I was checking out the guys' videos on this earlier, and I think it looks really, really cool. So yeah, we need to get ourselves a base location sorted so that we can go and build ourselves a tunnel in the nether to it. Get ourselves one of these fancy entrance things. Please follow the Netherhub guidelines at all times. Netherhub guidelines written in chess. Let's go take a look at this then. Please ensure you take a tunnel station on the correct line. The four branches of the hub contain six tunnel stations. Nice. Additional floors may be added in future. When building a tunnel, tunnels on the right side of the arms must dig at least three blocks down at the start of the tunnel. When building a tunnel on the left, must dig up at the start of the tunnel. Please work with your neighbours to ensure your tunnels do not collide. Please stick with tunnel dimension until further away from the hub. Make sure that you take a tunnel that goes towards your house. Don't take a tunnel that will require you to cut randomly in the way of other tunnels. Yeah, all pretty standard stuff. So yeah, I really, really like the look of this. We've got the portal set up in the middle here with these lava columns, which looks awesome. Little furnace area here. Turning the nether brick, I assume. I really like these corner bits. I like how they're all styled very differently. That's cool. Let's have a nosy in these chests. So they've got loads of netherrack. Yeah. So, yes, this is going to be Benito's village. Really like the look of that. So yeah, basically we can customize these to look however we want, which is awesome. What have we got here? This is Minnie's base. He was just showing me the top secret Brit base earlier on, the Parliament. Maybe we'll take a look at that later. That's slip gators. What have we got down here? Not sure whose that one is. What have we got through here? Just an open space, okay. Let's have a look down the other arms as well. Oh yeah, I wanted to have a look at this. This is Albanaka's entrance, which is really cool. He's got these flashing lights going on here. Does it go in a circle every time or is it random? Yeah, it goes in a circle. That's really cool. I like how that looks a lot. And then we've got Wooly's base. Wooly is lame, apparently. Yeah, really like that as well. Reserve for Nether Fortress Tunnel. Awesome, right? So things are really coming together on the Hypercraft server. Everything is looking really cool. Have we got anything else we haven't checked out yet? Nothing down here. Plenty of space though, so we should find ourselves a base location pretty quickly. But yeah, I think that is everything down here so far, so let's head back through the portal. And yeah, I will probably have a quick cut while I go and drop off some of my inventory and craft a new sword and stuff like that. So yeah, I will go do that and then I'll be right back. Okay, so I have sorted my inventory out, and I've legged it quite a long way away from spawn, and found this cave that looks quite promising, so we're going to start checking this out. It does look like it goes on for a while, which is pretty good. So, the main things we are looking for are redstone and diamonds, obviously, but we're still going to grab some iron as well. I know we've got the iron farm at spawn, but I do kind of want to collect my own iron. I don't mind using it if I need, say, some iron blocks for a building or something. Maybe I'll use it then, or if I need some iron in a pinch. But yeah, we're going to try and be more or less self-sufficient if we can. So, we will grab all this iron. Let's just keep an eye on things. We've got some coal as well, so I'm going to grab a few pieces of this as well. Probably should use my... Oh no, this is a fortune too, so that's okay. Let's just create ourselves a way out of here. And hopefully no creepers jump down and ruin our day. Bit of block lag there, it would look like. Okay, let's just light this up and then get out of here. We're going to get plenty of coal while we're exploring, no doubt. There we go, there's some more as well. And this cave looks like it keeps going down, which is good. We need to get down quite low to get to diamond layer. Let's just grab that iron as well. I should have made myself a... Let's just make a shovel really quickly. I forgot to bring one out with me. There we go. Whoops. We'll just make a stone one for now. And there we go. So, let's make ourselves a safe way down here. We'll do us. Let's just light this up properly. Looks like that keeps going as well. Oh, and we've got a ravine. Well, that's good. That's going to get us down to a diamond layer pretty sharpish. But before we do that, let's just grab this coal. Actually, let me just take a note of the time as well. There we go. Just so I know how long I've been recording. I think we've got a while for caving, but... yeah, this cave branches off in lots of different directions, but I think we should go and check out that ravine first. We can just dig our way down and then check that bottom layer out. But yeah, let's just grab a few more things before we go. Yeah, like I said, I'm not going to bother too much with coal because we're going to get plenty of that while we are caving. But I desperately, desperately need some redstone. And obviously diamond would be awesome too because then we could finally get an upgrade on our tools. We're going through iron picks rather sharpish. Okay, so which way was it now? I think it was this way to the ravine. Yes, it was. And we could actually just do this. And that would get us down there pretty quickly. Okay, so what layer are we at now? We are at layer 17, so we're actually just above diamonds. I think it's layer 12, is it? I always forget. Something like that. So, let's just get this lit up. Try and secure it at least a little bit, so we don't have anything spawning too close to us. Wow, this is a big ravine. Got some gold up there. Let's just pillar up and grab that real quick. Whoops. There we go. Don't really have too much gold. Don't really have a... Whoa! Yeah, I forgot about the gravel. Don't really have too much use for it either, but... we will grab it. Looks like that's a separate cave as well. Where's that going? Nowhere. I'm going to grab this lapis, though, because I've been using a lot of this stuff with the clay blocks, obviously. Let's grab that gold. And we will check out the rest of this ravine floor now. See if we can find any redstone or diamond, any easy stuff. There's gravel up there. I thought it might have been a spawner or something. It took a while for the lighting to update then. Okay, right. Looks like we've got some more lapis through there. Oh, and this keeps going. That's good. So we will keep going down this way. Doesn't look like this pick's got much more left in it, so I'm glad I brought some spares with me. Is that another ravine through there? Wow. Let's go check this. Let's have a look at this. Or is it just a... yeah, it's just a glitch. Although... that could well be a ravine. No, it was just... it wasn't loading in properly. Yeah, it's just a loading error. Okay, so where... I'm already lost. Where did we come from? Yep, I'm lost. Was it up this way? Yes, it was. Okay. So, let's just light this up, have a quick look down here. I can see an abandoned mine shaft over there. But anyway, let's go back and we will continue down, see if we can find ourselves any diamond down here. Ooh, redstone. Let's just light this up and then we'll go back for that. And actually, I think let's use our Fortune 3 pick on this. Might as well try and maximize what we get out of it. I shouldn't really be using this Fortune 2 as a standard caving pick, but why not, I guess. We've got Fortune 3 right now. Okay, so let's see if we can punch a hole through here. No, it just dead ends, so that's a shame. Well, at least we got 21 redstone, that's a start. I do have a, I've got some redstone lamps, on that spider spawner as well, but I've just got them hooked up to a switch right now. So I also want to hook that up. Oh, that looks like something. I also want to hook that up to a switch at the spawn, at where we stand waiting for the spiders, so that you can turn it on and off. Right now it's just always on. And that dead ends as well. Let's just grab a bit of coal. Use our good pick. Go. And we're going to have to think about making some more torches soon as well. So let's just temporarily do a few there. 38, actually, let's just do some more. Grab those. Oops. And we will stock up on torches. There we go. Got to get some diamonds down here, surely. We are layer 17. We're not really that far off. Here we go. Oops. Let's just grab that iron. And then we'll get down here. Let's just knock this water out. And let's head over that way, see if we can find anything useful. Oops. Is it going to knock that torch out? No. We're still good. Oh, I see redstone. And gold. Let's grab that. Yeah, I need lots of redstone, and I also... I'm going to have to do some slime hunting as well, because I'm going to need some sticky pistons soon. And we've got enough for a few, but not too many. Let's grab this stuff. That's it. Tempted to keep going that way. Let's just have a look up here real quick. We can always come back to this bit. Dead ends. We could probably dig that gravel out maybe if we wanted to try and go a bit further, but... And this is heading back up, so I don't really want to go this way right now. Yeah, there's certainly... caving's changed a lot over the course of playing Minecraft. I can remember when caves where you'd still get big, expansive cave networks, but you would come to an end at some point. You know, it was possible to sort of explore an entire cave system under your base or something. And now, they're just so huge and so intertwined that cave systems join up with cave systems, and you know, you can get lost for hours in these places now, which is a good thing and a bad thing. I kind of liked conquering a what's the word I'm looking for? Conquering a cave system, getting it all lit up, and knowing that you had it all done and dusted. Ooh, got some more redstone there. We'll go grab that actually. So let's just block this off. Actually, can we do it there instead? Yeah, you used to be able to, you know, completely light up a cave system and sort of clear it, as it were. Now you can just keep on going and going, which is good, because obviously caving is great. It's one of the things that drew me to Minecraft in the first place was the caving. I really liked the idea of it all. I don't know, a mix of larger caves, but with the ability to get them cleared. Obviously, when you used to go caving to light an area up for a mob system or something, it was a lot easier to do than it is now. Yeah, I don't really want to follow that either. Let's just light this up. Whoa. Lots of water around here. Oh, my redstone. Let's just grab that. Excellent. Light that up. We haven't seen any mobs in here yet. I'm not sure why. They're definitely on. Yeah, I did think I would see more mobs. Mind you, I'm not complaining. I don't really want to get blown up by a creeper again and lose all this redstone. Oops, we're using our good pick there, and we should be using that one. There we go. Yeah, I'm not going to follow that round either. Oh, I wish I had some ender balls so I could just quickly get out of this... a bit of water here. Come on, let me out. There we go. So that way leads up, but I guess it would have the possibility of leading back down again. But we are going to try through here, I think. Oops, there we go. Nothing through there. Need to be careful around these areas because we could have something drop down on us. I haven't even heard any zombies. Any mobs. I thought I would have at least heard some zombies. Let's just get our way up here. Grab that blue stone. Lapis. We'll grab that lapis. Bit more iron. Still no diamond though. Just checking the time there. I think we've still got a bit of time left. Don't want to spend too long doing this. Oh, we've got a stack and a bit of... just over a stack and a half of redstone. So that is mission successful to a degree. We can sort of put in a timed crusher now on the spider spawner. And also hook up the lights to a switch as well. So pretty pleased with this run. Just a shame we didn't find any diamonds. And that dead ends as well. Let's just have a quick look around here. Anywhere else we can go? Yeah, lots of different ways. There's redstone down there. Let's grab it. There we go. I end up with a couple of stacks of redstone out of this. Let's have a look. Yes, we're on the right track. And we're at level 11 as well, so we might be able to do a enchant when we get back as well. Or at least combine a couple of our bows. I did actually have a power 2 punch 1 bow back at the base as well, so I might combine that with the one we made earlier. And then I would get punch 2, I guess, and power 2, and what was the other thing we had on it as well? Flame 1, that's right. What level are we on? 16. So, we're moving back up again there now. Natural cobble generator. That's cool. Hey, is that a... is that gravel or is that a spawner? Wow, check this place out. It's kind of tempting to make our base inside a cave system. I think it's just gravel. Usually I sort of build... mostly I build above ground or just below ground level like I did in my single player Let's Play. Yeah, we've already been down that way. But yeah, it'd be interesting to do sort of like... oh, I heard something then. I think it was a spider. It'd be interesting to do a base that's a bit like Aether's sort of setup. Let's grab some more of this coal while we're here. And in the interest of saving a bit of space... oh, don't tell me I left the crafting bench. Alright, let's make a new one. And we'll grab that. Let's make ourselves some of those. Yeah, I had a ton of this stuff when I got blown up by that creeper as well. I had like 6 diamonds and a couple of stacks of redstone, and I lost the lot, so I was a bit miffed off at that. That's actually not saved me any space, but never mind. And let's just split up all the coal. Let's get all the coal sorted as well. There we go. Anything else? Oh, lots of gold. Did all right for that. Let's grab it back this time. So, we are actually running out of space to a degree. Let's grab some more coal while we're here. It'd be really nice if we could even just find just a couple of diamonds so we could make a sword or something. I guess once I get my base sorted, I will start doing a bit of branch mining, because that is obviously the quickest and easiest way to find diamonds. Not necessarily the most fun, but it does work in that way. That's lit up. Looks like we've actually covered quite a bit of ground in here. That's leading back up again. I really don't want to do that if we can avoid it. As is that as well. Anywhere else we can go down here? I don't think so. Let's just drop down. We've already been in this area. But that is not lit up. So, let's go check over here. Ah, yeah, this is the big canyon cave thing we found. It's already lit up, so I guess I have been down there. I'm not going to grab any more iron. I've got enough stuff on me now. Just want to try and find diamond if we can. I will grab that gold though. Force of habit. Yeah, so wherever that spider was earlier, it hasn't tracked us down. We still haven't seen any mobs at all. Which is really weird. We might have to have a word with someone, see if we are... I'm sure we've got mobs on. I'm sure we do. Yeah, we must have, because we just heard a spider. They're just not showing up right now. I should have done more than that. Let's grab ourselves a bunch of this. Oh, I already had some torches. There we go. Here's our abandoned mine shaft. It's just about down there. Gravel. And that dead ends as well. So maybe we could try down here. What level are we at now? 20 something. Let's just drop down here. Hope for the best. This looks like a new area. I don't think we've been down here. So let's just clear this lava out of the way. More redstone as well, so we'll grab that before we finish up. But yeah, we might just have to call this the end of our episode. I thought we would have found some diamond already at this, you know, coming down this low. Let's just grab that. There we go. And this as well. Definitely done alright for redstone, so that's at least something. Let's grab that gold. Ah yes, of course, we're going to need it for boost rails, that's right. I do have some plans for minecarts, and obviously we're going to need plenty of them for when we do our nether tunnel as well, so lots of gold will come in very handy. And now I think about it, we should have probably been grabbing more iron while we were going around as well. Let's light this up a bit. Still no diamond around there though. More redstone. Let's grab that. Might just have to admit defeat and head home. I don't really want to risk being down here too long in case we lose the redstone that we've collected, which would really suck. Let's grab this lapis again. We'll grab the blue stone. Oh, more redstone as well. It's just too tempting to pass up. Let's go grab that. Yeah, we could probably punch our way through. Doesn't look like we've got anything there either. So, whoa! Oh, no, we got it, we got it. No problem. What's through here then? This is just a one high area. Yep, I guess so. And it looks like it dead ends. Well, guys, I think I'm just going to admit defeat and I will probably just start digging straight up now, actually. Let's put that there. And let's get some cobble. I just heard a skelly. Yeah, I'm going to just dig straight up and get out of this place. Unfortunately, we didn't get any diamonds, but that's fine. We can have to be careful here. Yeah, we can start a branch mine going once we get to our regular base location. Well, once we find a base location anyway. Otherwise we could be at this for ages. Whoa. Although I do really like caving. But anyway, yeah. I'm going to call this the end of the episode, guys. So I hope you've enjoyed watching this. And I will see you soon for some more Minecraft. Peace.